Asken lässt sich echt viel Zeit mit den Quests. Okay, der hat hier etwas Dringendes. Und mal sehen, wie wir ihm helfen können. Askens gentle and mild demeanor has disappeared. His eyes are sunken from lack of sleep and he looks like he hardly has energy to speak. Oh, so you came. Sorry to have called you out of the blue. Something ridiculous has happened. I mean, you probably won't think much of it since it has nothing to do with you. But this is extremely important to me. I need to know what happened. Asken collapses into a chair. He's shaking as though feverish, but his eyes are focused and alive. So, suddenly he stands and grabs your hands. Thank you so much. You're the only one that cares, the only one who would help a useless old man like me. His eyes are uncomfortably intense. Asken swallows quickly. The muscles on his neck stand out as though strained. I found these strange letters, while reading through my parents' old things. These letters were requesting some ridiculous things from my family, and they were written under my name. My name. Asken grips his chest as though suffering a sharp pain. Please read these letters and understand. Whoever wrote these letters destroyed my family. They used my name to threaten my parents and to sell errands away in Emaimacha. I cannot let this go, Laterne. Never. Asken's sunken eyes do not blink. His body is tense and menacing. Find the person who wrote this letter. The letter mentions a merchant in Dumbarton. Talk to him for some clues. Asken grabs you by the shoulders and starts speaking quietly. This letter means so much. If I can find out who this person is... Asken's eyes fall as his voice trails off. You would be saving my life by helping me, Laterne. I'm begging you, please, for my family, for my sister. They never deserved any of this. Asken mumbles incoherently and bows deeply. Seine Schwester wurde verkauft wegen Drohbriefen, die angeblich Asken verschickt hat. Wo ist denn dieses Buch hier? Dieses Buch ist ein Brief. Asken's Scrapbook. I keep all my letters from Asken here. My heart breaks a little every time I read these. My poor child. Father, mother, I hope this letter finds you well. Thanks to the 50,000 gold you sent me, I was able to feed myself for another month and half. Thank you so much for your help. Unfortunately, things are getting worse here. Last week, one of the food ships sank in a big storm. Because of that, our rations have been cut in half, but my warlord, which includes webbing the deck and mending the sails and nets, stays the same. I don't know how long I'll have energy to do this. Please, if you can spare the money for your one and only son, send me just 100,000 gold. I should be able to last about 3 months with 100,000 gold. If that's not possible, please send me at least 50,000 gold. I think I could stretch that out for about 2 months. I can only hope that the situation will improve soon. P.S. I recently hurt my back. It's not serious, but my walk is making it worse. Could you send me some herbs for my back? Father, mother, I love you. Thank you so much. Because of your kindness, my back feels a lot better. I think there's hope. With the 100,000 gold you sent me, I was able to find a possible way out of this hell. With an additional 200,000 to 300,000 gold, I should be able to end my slavery and return home. Please, if you have any love left for me at all, please find some way to obtain the money for me. P.S. I was recently put in charge of the kitchen. Unfortunately, it's very difficult because there aren't enough pots. I have to cook all the night, through all the night, to make enough food for the next day. Can you please send me about 20 pots from the Dumbarton General shop? I'm so tired of walking through the night and getting any sleep and not getting any sleep. Okay, das sind keine Drohbriefe, das sind solche Enkel-Scam-Briefe. Also sozusagen sagen, jemand gibt sich als Asken aus und will Geld. Dear Arons, you are so immature. I've done some checking around and it seems that Vigorin is not only comes from a prominent family in Immermacher, he is also a man of great character. Why do you hesitate to marry such a man? I have to ask you to stop thinking about just yourself. Please consider me your only brother dragged to Belvis Island to suffer and toil through a hopeless existence. I apologize for getting upset. I'm truly sorry, but your marriage to Vigorin would be best for everyone. I hope that you will make the right decision. Please don't let mother and father know about this letter. Father, I'm dying. For the last few weeks, I've been walking out in the rain, in terrible storms. I have a fever and awful chills. I see things that aren't really there, but I am still not permitted a moment of rest. If I stay here, I'll die. The only way I can survive is to pay off these pirates and leave this hell forever. I didn't want to worry you, but I can no longer hide the truth. Please talk to Vigorin. I'm sure he could not refuse a request like this. Don't let me die like this. I want to live so that I can see you again. Please get me the money. Huh. Okay. Ja, habe ich schon im Detail gelesen. Kann ich das jetzt wegschmeißen? Also, warum blinkt mein Skillfenster? Naja. So. Hier. Walter in Dumbarton. Der verkauft ja diese Töpfe. Die von denen irgendwie 40 oder so, jedenfalls sehr viele, gekauft wurden und den Piraten geschickt wurden. Also ein langer Weg nach Dumbarton. Ich könnte ja ein Pet nehmen, aber ich bin zu faul. So weit ist es ja nicht mehr. Was steht denn hier eigentlich noch in der Quest selbst? Ja, das hatte ich schon vorgelesen. Genau. Okay. Hallo, Walter. What is it? Are you buying something? Walter does not look glad to see you. Do I look like an encyclopedia to you? Okay. Okay. He looks pleased as he smiles. Oh, what a polite person you are. So you want to know who bought those cooking pots? Let's see. I don't remember any of my regulars buying pots in bulk. Ah, Shivanin of Port Cove would come in here and buy a ton every now and then. It's not like that fella is in the trading business, so it was strange. I always wondered why he bought so many. If you're wondering about those cooking pots, then ask him. And if you're not buying anything, then leave. He turns his head as if he were greatly annoyed. Warum sind die immer so genervt, wenn man sie nach etwas fragt? Wovon die nichts verdienen können. Dann gehen wir wieder zurück. Und ich hatte angenommen, die Eltern hätten diese Töpfe gekauft oder haben sie nur jemanden beauftragt. So, der müsste irgendwo hier drüben sein. Die Musik ist sehr angenehm hier in Port Cove. Schön fröhlich. Okay, wo ist er denn jetzt? Hier ist er. Es ist ein Elf. Aber er ist doch Händler. Warum soll es denn ungewöhnlich sein, wenn er so viele Töpfe kauft? Ah, yes, the cooking pots. The merchant Videk had requested them several times, so I bought them from Walter for him. I certainly had no need for them. Now that I think about it, I haven't seen Videk in ages. Chauvinin mouse sprays as he talks. Oh, you don't know him, do you? He's a merchant from Belvest. Videk is a truly outstanding gentleman. I remember how he used to aid Asken's family in the old days. He helped then, even when that girl, Arons, wedded that fellow in Emelmacher. What a shame! She was blinded by money. Still, Videk would buy gifts from me for their family. He even managed to do it while in Belvest. That was true kindness. Chauvinin smacks his lips and frowns. I'm not sure why you're curious about those pots. Honestly, I'm not sure why Widdick wanted them either. I haven't seen him around much recently. For a while, he was taking care of Asken's sister when their parents passed away. Chauvinin pauses and he suddenly opens his eyes wide. I know you can ask for help. Who you... Okay, speak with Annick at the pub. She used to live on Belvest Island. She would certainly know more about Videk than me. He quickly returns to work. Okay, Videk wollte diese Töpfe haben. Und die Person in der Kneipe kennt ihn, weil sie mal in Belvest gewohnt hat. Dann gehen wir mal rein und kaufen uns etwas Alkohol. Annick. Ahoy there! Welcome to the finest pub in Port Cove. We are also the only pub in Port Cove. So you don't really have a choice, do you? Haha, I'm just pulling your tail. Well, what are you here for anyway? Did you come to see my pretty face? Annick looks at you playfully. You know when you see beauty, muhahaha. Sorry, but you're not my type. Well then, come back when you're older, hahaha. Annick averts her eyes briefly as though distracted. She then raises an eyebrow quickly. Videk, that name sounds familiar, but from where? Ah, right, he was a merchant. Oh, that name on Belvest. There was a merchant of that name on Belvest Island. To be honest, I've seen him only a few times. I've never had much to do with him. But you're saying that he was kind to Asken's family? Wahahaha. Annick doubles over with laughter. Oh, my sides. Yes, Widdick is a kind person indeed. He just can't abide to see people in need. She tries to keep a straight face, but bursts into laughter again. Oh, my stomach, I can't breathe. Finally, she manages to calm down. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Don't know what got a hold on me. I don't know much about Widdick, but I know a man who does. Ask the rich man in Emelmacher. Those two are old partners. He's a kind man too, just like Widdick. Annick snaps her fingers and looks directly at you. You seem pretty close to Asken. Would you mind delivering that to him? Someone left it here for him some time ago. I would deliver it myself, but I were a pirate, savvy? Asken was a slave. I don't imagine he would appreciate the likes of me. All right. I've got things to do. Off with thee. No. Don't forget to deliver that letter. Oh, sie war mein Pirat. Ach, das sind noch mehr Briefe, die ich hier bekommen habe. Letter an Asken. Okay. Das sind also die Briefe, die die Familie an den falschen Asken geschrieben hat. Oh, das sind 7 Seiten. Okay. They're quite an interesting read. I had no idea what my little project would end up making me so much money. It's just a shame that I can't get any more money from Asken's parents. Still, I have errands, so I need not to worry about those poor fools anyway. Also ist der Betrüger, der Mann, der Arens geheiratet hat. My son, it's already been 10 years since we lost you. I heard from Vidic that you hurt your back. I'm sending you 10 white herbs bundles and 10 bloodier bundles to aid you in your recovery. I hope they get you back on your feet soon. We, along with Vidic, are still trying to find a way to bring you back to Port Cove, but if only we had more money. Vidic tells me that we'll need 10 million gold. Unfortunately, after 10 years of hard work, I've only been able to save about 1 million. I gave Vidic the 1 million gold last month, and he said he would do what he could. Unfortunately, he said later that he hasn't been able to accomplish much with such a small amount. But don't worry, no matter what it takes, we will never give up on you. Please remember that your mother, your sister and I love you very much. Please take care of yourself, my son. Alastair. Das ist der Vater oder die Mutter? Ach, keine Ahnung. My lovely Asken, how are you? Are you eating well? I heard from Vidic that your life is a little better after the pirates plundered that large merchant ship. I'm saddened to think about the poor crew of the ship, but I can't help but feel relieved at the thought of your life improving and at all. Vidic told us that he needs 2 million more gold. Unfortunately, we just don't have that kind of money. In truth, your father's health has been deteriorating as of late. Your father hasn't been able to work for a few weeks now, so we barely have any money left. Oh, if only we were rich, we could have rescued you by now. I'm so sorry that there is so little we can do for you. I feel like a failure as a mother. I do have a little good news about Arendt, though. Your sister may be getting married soon. A gentleman from Emaimacha named Vigorin met Arendt by chance and has completely fallen in love with her. She has been courting you. He has been courting your sister constantly over the last few days. I've met him, and though he is a bit older, he seems like a honest man that will make your sister very happy. I ask Arendt about how she feels, but she doesn't seem to want to talk about it. If Arendt were to marry him, 2 million gold should be no problem. I'm afraid this war subject has caused some arguments between your father and I, though. Your father is overly concerned about the age difference. I think, in my opinion, a few gray hairs is nothing. Vigorin is plenty young and healthy to me. A few days ago he went fishing with the servants and caught a 4-foot ich kann das nicht lesen. Hanblay long all by himself. He gave that fish to us as a gift. We had it for dinner, and I think it helped your father's health. In any case, please don't worry about us too much. In the end, Aaron's marriage is up to her and her alone. No matter who it's with, I just want Aaron's to marry someone nice soon. Vidic says that he has to leave soon, so I'll cut my letter short. My lovely Asken, please take good care of yourself. Gwendolyn. My brother, father has died. His health kept getting worse and worse, but I was stuck in Emailmacher until he passed away. My husband, Vigorin, is sometimes as kind and warm as Palala, but at other times he is as cold as Ladeka. For some reason, Vigorin hates father and Vidic so much. He gets upset if I even mention them. Oh, how long must I live like this? Now that father has passed away, I have no one that I can depend on. If you were here, I know you would be there for me. Just like that one night, Vigorin wants me to return to Emailmacher right after father's funeral. But then who will take care of mother? Even for the funeral, Vigorin sent a watcher with me saying they were my bodyguard. Now that I've seen how much mother has aged in the last few years, I can't bear the thought of leaving her alone again. Just last night, we spent so many hours just holding each other and crying. Mother really misses you. She said that father was so worried that he might die before seeing you. Again. He begged mother to live long enough to see you. Seeing mother's frail hands brings me such pain. I only wish I could take her back to Emailmacher. However, she is adamant about staying in Port Cove until you return. I was even able to convince Vigorin to allow mother come to Emailmacher, but she will have none of it. If it wasn't for Alexen, I would just remain in Port Cove. I just can't bear the thought of her growing up without her mother. She would be so lonely in that big mansion without anyone to take care of her. I wish you could see her. She's such a pretty girl. I took her to Tara recently to get her portrait done so that I can send it to you. It's enclosed with this letter. I'm also sending 100,000 gold to you via Vidic, so please buy yourself some clothes, some warm clothes and good food with it. I wish I could send you more, but it's rather hard to save up money without Vigorin knowing. So this is all I have to send you for now. And please don't worry about me too much. Vigorin is getting more and more frickle as he ages, but he's not really a bad person. He's usually very kind to me, as long as the issue of money doesn't come up. He even bought me a pretty dress recently. It was made by a famous tailor in Tara. I'm glad to see that Vidic is doing well. He's such a wonderful person for delivering letters to you without any sort of compensation. I really hope I'll be able to compensate him someday. Also, don't worry about mother too much. I'll find someone in Port Cove to take care of her. I'll continue sending letters to you from Emailmacher. I love you, brother. One day we will meet again. Okay, aber das Bild von ihr ist nicht hier dabei. Ich sehe es nicht. Gut, geben wir es dem Askolm. He seems to have more wrinkles on his face than he did a few days ago. Ah, you're finally back. I was beginning to get worried. Were you able to talk to Walt in Dumbarton? Was he able to tell you who wrote that letter? Did you by any chance hear anything about my sister? Ich gebe ihm den Brief. He trembles as he holds the letter and reads. He's biting his lips so hard they might bleed. So, this was all my fault? Exasperated, Asken plops down into the chair. I should have never been born. I'm the one to blame for all my family's tragedy. I'm the one to blame for the vanishing of my sister. They would have never fallen for this scam, were it not for me. Asken stares at the ground in silence. I know this is a lot to ask. You've already done so much for me. Could you find the person who wrote this letter? Perhaps Widdick would help me. He helped my family some time ago. Maybe he knows who the crook is. Asken shudders as if struck by a frightening thought. You're the only one I can trust, Laterne. I've kept a treasure from my time in Belvest. I was holding it for my sister until now, but I'll give it to you if you just do this for me. Just find the crook for me, please. I have nothing else left. Asken stares at the ground. It might be a good idea to help leave him alone for now. Okay. Die Schwester ist sie jetzt eigentlich mittlerweile gestorben? Und was ist mit der Tochter von seiner Schwester? Lebt die noch? Ich weiß, dass es hier in Port Cove das Grab seiner Familie gibt. Wir werden einfach mal dorthin gehen. Und dann können wir ja sehen, ob das Grab seiner Schwester dabei ist. Oder wäre sie in Emainmacher vergraben worden? Ich glaube, das war hier in dieser Ecke. Aber vielleicht steht das auch hier auf der Karte? Genau, hier oben. Also hier hoch. Irgendwie hier hoch. Und da sollte dann das Grab sein. Und wo ist es da? Hier haben wir zwei Gräber. Wahrscheinlich Mutter und Vater. Gwendolyn's Grave und Alastair's Grave. Ja. Also die Eltern von Asken. Gut. Die Quest wird wohl auch etwas länger dauern, bis sie kommt.